I'm basically an intensely ordinary person, but I have this little spark magnetic mark. And although I can't read teacups, I can get certain vibes from footwear. It's called pedomancy. It's an old, old thing they used to read.
Hope that's decent.
In the Middle Ages. Yes, pedomancy. Pedo means right. A shoe. And pedal, you get it in bicycle pedal, another little Greek word for any Open University viewers watching. And you swirl, you know, in a teacup. I'm not just talking to the viewers, I'm talking to little studio people, because every technician in the business is here. And this is a compliment to me, Kay, darling. I don't know if people watch you when you make your little jams, because I don't know if you know that Kay is an expert jam maker. She is. She's a versatile little miss. But I've got all these technicians watching me just to see if I can teach them a few little tricks of the trade. And the trick for me is naturalness, because I'm completely natural. Now, I swirl shoes around, and just as you get tea leaves sticking to the side of the cup, with a shoe you get, oh, little verruca cores and little bits of consolidated talc. Sounds like a stock market, doesn't it? Consolidated talc has risen 3 points. And corn plastered, in this case, it's a very open sort of ended shoe, showing a very, very open and direct person. And also a person, I think, very conscious of your feet, because you expose a lot of your foot here, and I think you're rather proud of your feet. You're not a vain woman, but your assets you believe in, shall we say, you believe in putting your best foot forward, and I use that in a metaphorical sense. Metaphors are very in, by the way, for any Open University people watching.
There's a bit of your life we don't know about yet.
Did you buy these in Venice when you were there recently on holidays?
Who told you?
I sense Venice. I feel canals, and particularly gondoliers.
Listen, I must get this from you, because I'm a bit worried about you. On your show, and actually when you were interviewed by the press beforehand, you said that you had a secret trauma, that something's the matter. Now, I wondered whether you're in the privacy of our studio now, whether you could, I don't know, divulge and share with us what's worrying you, Dame
Edna. Well, I had a little bit of PMT. What woman hasn't?
PMT?
Yes, it's a little thing you get. It's initials for something. I'm not going to say things. This is a family show.
Oh, we talk about that kind of thing on our show.
And I've had to have a few little exploratories recently. I have, as a matter of fact. I was in Harley Street this morning. Harley Street, for provincial viewers, is a street in London where a lot of doctors live and specialists. And I popped in there and I had every top man going over me this morning. Look, they were swarming over me. And afterwards I said, well, what's the verdict? Because I was worried, you know. Not that anything had happened, but I was a little bit worried. And they said, well, we'll write to you. I said, oh, no, that's not good enough. I said, I'm not putting my clothes on till you've all given me the thumbs up. And, you know, well, 3/4 of an hour later, I left that place a happy woman. I did.
Are you really Dame Edna, or are you a drag artist? Sorry, but it's got to be
asked. What is a drag artist, darling? I'm sorry, it's not a term I know.
Well, that is a man who dresses up as a woman.
Or a woman who dresses up as a man.
I'm not sure if it
works
that way.
Let me say,
yes,
I have never
does.
Put the clothes of the opposite sex on my body. Furthermore, I've read in some of the papers about certain people who lock the door and do silly things with stockings and what have you. I'm sorry, what troubled, what disturbed people they are. My heart goes out to their families. Imagine opening your father's wardrobe, you know, and finding pantyhose.
I think we'd better go on.
Wouldn't it be a heartbreak? You know, I'm not a superstitious woman, because I'm as left wing as they come, as a matter of fact. I'm really Australia's answer to Jane Fonda, viewers. But, you know, a cross between Vanessa Redgrave and Jane Fonda, as a matter of fact. I'm the acceptable face of socialism. But Australian socialism, that is, which is very special.
Now, you're not superstitious, but
you do... But I'm not, but I am get spooky feelings.
You do, but you believe in your stars. You're an Aquarian.
Well, I am, and I think that we are a very talented sign. There's no two ways about that, Kay. What are you, incidentally?
I'm an Aquarian.
You are, darling. And what's Adam, your husband?
How did she know that?
He's Adam, I love Adam. He rings me at all hours saying, oh.
Are you a liberated woman? I mean, to all intents and purposes, you go all round the world, and yet, in a sense, you have to rely on this one man, Barry Humphries. Now, how do you get over that, Dame Edna?
Well, I am dependent. I'm not a liberated woman, I'm afraid. I have an invalid husband who's very close to me, although he's in Melbourne.
But you've left him. I mean, you're here.
There's nothing, you see, what you have to learn, darling, you have a healthy little Adam and you've got your jam and you've got your career. But for me, I have to learn something that everyone in life, and here's a lesson for you, have to learn to detach with love. Detach with love. DWL. Think about that. Forget about PMT. Let's move on to DWL. If you've got an invalid, let the doctors do the doctoring. You've got to cherish them. You've got to care for them. You've got to show them everything. Or if you've got any problem in your life. But there's a point where you have to share that problem.
How would you cope with being a flop? I mean, you're right on the crest of a wave. How would you cope?
Acceptance. Detach with love. If I had a little failure, I'd think, that makes me human. A lot of people think I'm a goddess. Admittedly, I'm physically attractive. At my age, and I'm not divulging it, I still have my drives. I have my juices. I'm intensely attractive to men. If I stay in a luxury hotel, I can barely sleep from little taps on the door. And that's the thing, and women adore me, you know. Women want to cuddle me and hug me, and I don't mean that in a permissive, horrible, you know, sort of Billie Jean way. I don't mean that. I listen to the technicians. They're technicians in the studio coming to learn a little bit about...
Sue Goddard of Surrey.
If Sue, you... hello, Sue in Surrey.
If you could take one man on a desert island, who would it be?
It's always been Parky, but I can't say that with Mary here, can I?
Not really.
I can't really. Peter Ustinov, who I resemble in many ways. People have called me the female equivalent of Peter Ustinov.
For your wit, you mean?
For my wit, because I'm very good on my feet. Whereas most women in the television that I know are better, well, perhaps off their feet.
Pat McLean of South Wales, what do you think of Englishmen?
I love Englishmen. I love their reserve. A lot of Australian men, I think, a little too... Well, they say exactly what's on their mind. I think we Australians are blunt. We're very direct. And I think that's why British people love us. I think we're more popular with the British than the Canadians and the Kiwis. I don't think there's any doubt about that. I think people like the idea of Australia. And I think I've helped popularise my country. And it's been a task I've done with a lot of joy. But I love Englishmen. I like their manners. You know, I've been treated so kindly by Englishmen. They've been so rough yet gentle with me. I mean that, I don't mean that playing hospitals with them. I haven't had that experience. If anything happened to Norm, I shouldn't laugh, of course. But he's in really such good hands that I don't think anything is likely to happen to him. And I wouldn't marry immediately. I couldn't. I've discussed this with my husband. What a very, very... thoughtful woman I am in many ways, to go to my husband's bedside and discuss frankly with him the possibilities of my remarriage if anything horrid happened to
him. You've even bought him a plot in Melbourne Cemetery, haven't you, already?
I have, as a matter of fact. I showed him some photos. I said, did he want to be under a tree or did he want to be in the open, near the gate? I've shown him these things.
What did he say?
Because I think he should have a say in the matter.
What did he say?
Well, he was a bit emotional, as a matter of fact, because, of course, I don't think he was quite prepared. I think he was overwhelmed by my thoughtfulness.